coming up, we all want our kids to be healthy, but sugar makes its way into their diets at every turn. We're talking with Dr. Thompson about the importance of good nutrition early on. What it is like to have a sweet tooth. Some of us never outgrow it, but that sweet tooth can start earlier and earlier lately, it seems. The CDC reporting recently that 60% of children consume added sugar before they're even 1 year old. So how do we keep them on track for a healthier lifestyle? And what's the impact of all that sugar? Dr. Sharon Thompson is joining us with some good nutrition practices that we should really be incorporating if we've got a little one at home. Good topic. Thank you for being here.
It is so common. Most of us think of candy, and we can avoid that and say no, but there's so many hidden sugars that get under the radar for parents. And processed cereals are a big one.
Yeah.
You know, I always say beware the stroller tray.
Okay.
Right? You're pushing baby in the stroller and you have a few, what do people like, Cheerios.
And,
you know, those fish.
A goldfish, lots of goldfish.
To me, those aren't even food. But and so those have a lot of added sugars. They're flour and carbohydrates. And so those sneak under the radar for parents. Mm-hmm. Also juices are a big culprit. So we all think of juice as a good thing, right? Mm-hmm. Well, juices are a lot of sugar and they take away the fiber and the other nutrients that are in the fruit.
And that's really one of those habits that's so tough to break, because once they get a taste for having a Gatorade or apple juice, to serve water even on ice with a squeeze of citrus gets a big frowny face.
Yes, I don't think I've broken my habit yet. So it can take a long time to break those habits once they start.
I have noticed, at least particularly with my son, a change in behavior can be connected to a lot of consuming the sugar that maybe he's not used to. A special occasion, you go out to a party.
Absolutely.
And really, even the following day, there's a change in patience and irritability, all of it. How does sugar impact the body? I mean, just for all of us.
So sugars, one, in small children, sugars are setting their sort of eating habits and their taste buds and their taste preferences. So that's super important. Whereas an adult, we're sort of fixed. Like I said, I still have my habits. But children, you're setting what they will do going forward. So that's one super important way. But physically, sugars are for energy. Yeah. And when you have more energy than you need, you store it.
Okay.
So you start storing fat. Mm-hmm. And so those fat cells get primed for storage. Also, some of it can end up in our livers. So we can wind up with fatty livers as we grow up and we're consuming too much sugar. And those things put us at high risk for obesity, diabetes, hypertension, and other health effects.
Well, and that's an important point, because we think about gaining weight, we think about it just in terms of aesthetics. But when you've got that fat that's accumulating on the outside of the body, it's also accumulating around the organs, right?
Definitely. And that can definitely have impacts on your cardiovascular health, your heart health. I mean, heart disease is the number one killer of all of us. And those added sugars can really have an impact on your risk for that.
And you talk about developing habits. I know many of us grew up with, if you're sad, here's a cookie. Being rewarded rewarded for good behavior with sugary treats, or consoled for sad feelings. And those are really bad habits to break, and hard habits to break.
That is such a hard habit for adults to break. I talk to my patients about, humans have an instinct to feed.
Yeah.
And so you get a boo-boo, oh, let me give you a cookie, let me give you a cake. Something exciting happens, let me reward you with food. That is such a hard instinct. But the more you can resist that and maybe do some activities, oh, you got an A, let's go to the park.
Yeah.
Oh, you fell down, or your friend hurt your feelings, let's go to a movie, instead of reacting with food every time, and definitely with the sugary treats.
Yes, start early. It makes it easier to be healthy when you don't have to change everything
you
got so accustomed to. Dr. Thompson, thanks so much.
Oh, you're
You can find Dr. Thompson at Central Phoenix Obstetrics and Gynecology.
Thanks for having me.